This is Magnum Muskox, Towerfest 8, stepping in to commentate so you don't have to listen to background chatter anymore. So we're at Losers? No, this isn't Losers Finals, is it? What happens? Alright, so looking like game one here, Captain PK and Appleturk versus CPO Injustice. Surprisingly, CPO Injustice are in the lead. This is Loser's Semis here. Yeah, Link is... FRO. No D in there. There we go. Alright, sorry. We're just pulling up the bracket on challenge.com. Destroyed. Appleturk and Captain PK bringing home game one. Sounds like they're banning Lylat. Nobody likes Lylat. Captain PK and Appleturk with the tag Kirito, but Mario and Bowser.
Yeah. Okay, we are sharing a mic. Very close together.
Very close. This is very intimate. So, Appleturk and Captain PK is a last-minute teaming. Both showed up without partner this morning, so they're doing pretty good for not having practiced at all.
I'm salty that me and Gen didn't beat them.
CPO and Justice, on the other hand, friends outside of Smash, and I would hope that they practiced a little bit before this.
They have practiced things very much. We usually, we don't get the practice things very often, but they are actually fairly good. It's interesting, though, that Carl's playing Game & Watch, because he does practice that Game & Watch every month, but I don't think he gets the results.
Pit is a better brawler in a large setting like this.
Pit, his Cloud is what I would recommend. Not Game & Watch.
Yeah, as we can see,
Carl is losing stock. Apparently, Game & Watch is a marginally better character in Kings than Singles.
Did not know that. Oh, the bullet bomb. No, not gonna take the stock. Still very nice, though. Bowser's shield is pretty low. I don't think that's gonna be capitalized on, though. There goes Villager. Which is kinda surprising. Villager usually has a long life in these doubles. Everybody pairing off. As per usual.
Justice and Carl their strategy is to get Justice to try to give Appleturk as much as possible.
Yeah, well, you always want to take out the weakest link.
Also, just the slingshot thing is so easy against Bowser.
Yeah.
And Justice tends to have a history of that. There. Just like that.
That's his first stock. Okay. They have a ways to go here if they're going to bring it back. Oh, the toot-toot! Nice.
Unfortunately, killing his teammate.
Oh, that tough guy ever keeps taken by the rocket. Slingshot at close range came off of it.
Oh, the slingshot. The cape just turned over time.
Although, if you cape Peach's counter, it'll just turn her... It'll trigger her counter, and then trigger it against her.
Cool.
Yeah.
That's interesting, so that doesn't have to have 3 moves of cost?
No. I don't know if it's a timing specific one or not. I've only seen it a couple times. Okay.
What's the right situation there?
Bringing it back. Good forward throw. Don't want to back throw that.
Dude, we just saw there for a second the perfect example of what Justice is trying to do. He just trying to carry him as far as he can with slingshot. PK's giving him his thing play.
Yeah. In this situation, I think coaching is allowed because it's not really coaching.
Oh
no! That was beautiful.
And they kill both of them.
Oh no, and he doesn't capitalize on the balloon.
Justice often goes for many unsafe
goes,
even if it makes no sense.
Yes, no, makes it back anyway. No, what?
Hey.
Oh, takes the game. Premature fist bump.
So whose plate is this? This beautiful pearlescent plate.
It sounds like it is just best of three.
It is just best of three.
Alright. Game is over. Game goes to PK and...
It's Lizard Finals coming right away.
Although, yeah. Alright, this is Magnum Muscle.